On behalf of the students, staff, and administration of Santa Fe High School, we invite you to rejoice in tonight's production of Sister Act. And now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage Miss Dolores Van Cartier.
She looks so classy and she's saying, "Ah, that's it. Open it." problem blue with secret.
Hey, where's the problem? What's it say?
Cynthia.
Ooh, Cynthia. Is that the new shop on Market? No, Cynthia's the wife on Rittenhouse Square.
I don't believe it. The man gave me his wife's coat. Merry Christmas to me.
You know, my psychoanalyst says that women always date their fathers.
That's stupid. I never knew my father. He walked out on us. All I ever heard about him is how bad he was.
So you date men who are bad, who walk out on you, and that you'll never truly know. You want a cigarette?
You know what? I can do undiscovered all by myself. I don't need Curtis. I have had it.
You have had nothing. You better just shut up, sit down, and do what Curtis says.
No, not this time. I've been hearing shut up and sit down since first grade at St. Mary's. 12 whole years of those nasty old nuns seeing what I can be. Then producers, promoters, club owners, the jar never varies. I'm too this, I'm too bad, I'm too much, I'm not quite, I'm too loud, too demanding, too wrong, too not right. Well, too bad if they think I should stay out of sight. Honey, open your eyes, let me show you the light. Goodbye, Chris Jackson. I don't need the club, I don't need the blue bar, and I don't need you. Look at my style, could it be more glam? Look at my look, can you say yes, ma'am? Look, and I want you to know what I am. I'm a fearless baby. Look at my moves, don't they blow your mind? Drama and talent, it's all combined. You can tell even if you're blind. See, I'm a fearless baby. I'm meant to be where the spotlight shines. You want to be on display. You could be dressed to the 1990s and ready.
Oh, I do love a good joke, boss.
Okay, knock, knock.
Who's there?
What were you doing yesterday at 4 p.m. talking to an officer Eddie Souther at the police station?
What were you doing yesterday afternoon at 4 p.m. talking to an officer Eddie Souther at the police station?
One of my boys is talking to the police. My gut tells me it's you, Ernie.
It wasn't me, boss. It was Joey.
I want to tell you, boss. I love you.
TJ?
No,
Stop it, that tickle.
Pablo.
Boss, I didn't tell on you.
So none of you are talking?
No, I wouldn't even know how.
Well, then I guess I just gotta go and look at it.
I saw nothing. Just now. Just the whole mess and nothing. I was just coming here to, thank you for the stunning blue bar. And it goes with everything. Oh, look. Ernie's taking a little nap so we can go to some after parties later. Dolores. A little disco nap.
Dolores.
You mustn't wake Ernie. I'm just gonna tiptoe on out of here and see what else my blue fur goes with. Just slide on out of here. Again, saw nothing. Nothing.
Paul, what do we do? Bring her back. It's time me and Dolores have a little chat.
What if she doesn't want to come back?
Kill her.
And you need protection, and there's no better protection like the Philadelphia Police Department. We need to hide you.
You can't hide me? How are you gonna hide me? How are you gonna hide all of this?
Here's a picture of the last guy who talked, or at least what's left of him.
Oh my God, you have to help me.
Then we need to disguise you, and we need a place he'd never think to look.
But what's gonna happen to me?
He will kill you, so we need to hide you.
You mean I gotta go incognito?
Wait a minute. I have the perfect place. Let's go.
But what about your gun?
Guns make me nervous.
Look, ain't this my lucky day? I got a man who wants to kill me and a cop without a gun. Good, good.
Church.
Yes, I've heard those rumors.
An offer has been made to purchase the church.
Who would buy the church?
Two bachelors who deal in antiques. Just last week I saw them eyeing the church, loudly say the word God 3 times, and cling to one another for support.
No one will buy this church. Who is that at this hour?
The Philadelphia Police Department. They need to hide a wayward woman in our convent.
A wayward woman? But Monsignor, I don't.
They are making a generous financial donation.
I see.
Think of it as a test. Coming!
Dear God, if this is a test, I cannot fail with you by my side. May she be a faith of modesty.
Whoa, would you look at this place? Damn!
Perhaps the choir of angels drowned me out and you did not hear me, Lord. Faith, modesty, calls.
Well, look what you're wearing.
When I got dressed this morning, did I know if there was going to be a murder? And what's with all that smoke in here?
Incense.
That ain't no incense. Somebody's smoking weed.
Mother Superior, this is Dolores.
Dolores Van Cartier, as in Cartier's.
Thank you, Mother Superior, for letting her stay here for the month.
What? A month? This is the perfect place?
Yes, all you have to do is stay quiet, be inconspicuous.
Inconspicuous? How could she be inconspicuous? An eon sign with your Wawa food market would be less conspicuous.
Mother Superior.
Pardon us for a moment.
You took a vow of charity.
I took it back.
Mother Superior.
I suppose if it must be, then it must be.
It must be.
Very well then. Welcome to Queen of Angels.
Thank you.
Come, Officer Southern, let us make reparations, and there's a tawny port you might enjoy before Mass.
Behave yourself. Mm.
Well?
Yes.
Okay! Ooh, great acoustics! I'm in a church! With a bunch of nuns! Yeah, I like that reverb. Hey, Mother May, when this is all over with, do you mind if I borrow the space for a couple of weekends, you know? Fridays, Saturdays.
Sundays are usually booked.
Hey, I was gonna say thank you for letting me stay here, and I say this to people all the time. I really love what you nuns are doing. I dig your work. I mean, at the end of The Sound of Music, when you nuns steal the Nazis' car parts and machine and children from your wife, that's good stuff.
Thank you.
Yeah, so these are my ground rules. I want 3 meals a day and 2 rooms. One for my clothes and one for my downtime.
And these are my rules. You will stay in your room, and when you are not in your room, you will behave as a nun. Do you know how a nun behaves?
Hey, I went to Catholic school when I was a kid.
The benefits of which are quite apparent. You will only leave your room for meals or prayer. Do you pray, child?
Oh, well, there was this one time I saw Donna Summer. She had a white sequin dress on and a white fox fur, and I said to myself, dear God, I wish I had that dress. Did that count as a prayer?
No. The material world has no value in here. This is a different world you enter now. Behind these walls, we live a life of adoration and grace. This is a sanctuary. Outside, like some myths. No one's fair or spirit any longer. There's no wrong or right, just wrong and wronger. People have amused themselves to death. Outside, life is green. Filled with smut and scandal to the brim. I suppose there could be room for you. Frankly, I don't plan to hold my dress. But here within these walls, days are filled with grace. God is in his place. His wisdom still respected. Here within these walls, life has a different pace than life beyond our doors. And for its worth, this life's now yours.
Oh, hey, can I get a light? I saw a mess of candles the other morning.
Not in here.
Oh, is there a smoking section?
Oh, yes, dear. And you're headed for it. Sigh, all is vice. People now are absolutely shameless. Most including those who shall be nameless. Hardly seem to know or even care. Outside, all is sin. And I don't have the outside coming in. Trust me, it's a battle you won't win. Frankly, dear, you haven't got a prayer. Miss Van Cartier, as long as you will reside here, you must divest yourself of all worldly possessions. Is that clear? So put aside your gluttony, to sight or pride. As for Colonel Lust, he'll need a break, I trust. Put it all aside. Put aside intemperance. Profanity is well. Put aside each remnant of your fatherly shame. Now, when you leave your room, you must wear this habit.
No way.
Pardon me.
Dress it up a little bit.
We have worn this since the 14th century. It does not cry out for accessories.
But if I wear this on, it's drop dead.
Then we have a plan. We are within these walls.
She's honest in what a holiness.
Look at this huge creeping penguin dress.
Look at this place. This is hell, I guess.
So hard that he was here with the cheese double.
Sister Mary Clarence, my name is Mary Patrick, and I just want to say welcome And I was wondering if you would lead us in prayer.
I shall pray with Sister Mary Clarks. She's taken a vow of modesty and eschews all attention. Let us pray. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Ghost.
Holy Ghost.
Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name.
Hallowed
be thy name.
Thy
kingdom for a horse, and yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of no food, I shall fear no hunger. We want you to give us this day our daily bread, and to the public for which it stands, and by the power invested in me, I pronounce us ready to eat at last. Eat at last! Thank God Almighty, we can eat at last.
Amen.
Let's eat. What is this stuff?
It's mutton.
Mutton? What part of the store? No, what part of the zoo? Can you find it in the zoo?
Sister Mary Clarence.
It ain't mutton, it ain't nothing.
Perhaps they ritualize fast. Will help Sister Mary Clarence understand the measure of her devotion.
A fast? Now we're talking.
No, I'm hungry. Come on, I'm hungry.
Sisters, I shall leave you to your profound contemplation.
Who else but a nun gets to fast? Sister Mary Clarence, what's your favorite part about being a nun? Come on, there's so much to choose from. The joy of waking up at 4 a.m. right on the dot. The thrill of meditating all day long in just one spot.
Or how about reading scripture till your eyes begin to glaze?
Or basking in the magic of your favorite Latin phrase.
The peace when you surrender all your pride.
Your name,
your gender.
Consuming holy wafers by the ton. Yum! It's racy.
It's a tonic.
It's a moral high tonic.
Praise the Lord, it's good to be a nun.
It's grim and unrelenting, but for those who love repenting.
Praise the Lord,
it's good to be a nun.
No, forgot the best part.
Oh, yeah? Confessing for an hour,
don't
worry.
Or teaching the little children how to keep their hearts
clean. The sensation of each kiss of graduation
and genuflection is always pretty fun. And didn't even mention all the sexual abstention.
What
is good to be a nun?
And hey, that's just for starters.
All the lucky girls are martyrs. Sacrifice,
humility,
obedience,
hooray!
Oh yes, indeed.
And only when you're miserable can you feel truly blessed.
So, sister, spotlight's back on you. Your turn.
All right. My favorite part about being a nun.
Yes.
The answer combo mixers?
What?
TV not. How about that? We say there's a jacuzzi where you sisters sit and chat.
You're funny.
A house bar.
No.
A tape deck? Cigarette machines?
No.
Or maybe just a room with some old people magazines.
Oh, you.
A couch, a comfy chair, a private bathroom,
central air.
I don't need them all, just maybe one.
Wow, your old order was really
all that I can say is, damn, I guess I'm ready for it.
Praise the Lord, it's good to be a nun.
The
strictness of compassion, the extremeness of the yester,
the praying
of the kneeling,
all that precious baptized feelings.
The subjection, why it's practically perfection.
Jesus, take your little work, have I done.
Yes, the world's your oyster when you're locked inside a cloister. Hallelujah, it's good to be a praise the Lord, it's good to be a glory be, it's good to be a nun. Amen.
A fast will bring you an awareness of life that can do you some good.
You don't need to tell me about my life. That wasn't part of the deal. You telling me about my life. My life is great.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
In a city with over 1 million people, and you don't have a single friend who would take you in. At a time when success in the music business is blossoming and you can't get a job. And when your married lover finds out what you've done, he will try to kill you. God has sent you here for a reason, child. Take the hint.
Don't tell me where I'm going. And my life is great, okay? Oh, Sister Mary, Sister
Robert.
Sister Mary Robert. Do you know if there's any loaf of bread or bottle of wine from Camino that needs to be thrown out? Because I'm starving. I will throw it out right now. Never mind, good night.
I hope that dreadful noise doesn't keep you up all night.
Noise?
From that bar.
Bar?
Oh, it's this terrible place with cigarette smoke.
No.
And alcohol.
Terrible.
And cheese steaks.
Where is this place?
Across the street.
I'm gonna go shut it down right now. Want to be back up?
Mary Clarence, we never leave the convent. Mary Clarence? Mary Clarence!
Let's go, Celine. She needs backup.
Hey, knock it off. Didn't realize you were so delicate.
Everything in order?
Bill's set off, Mr. Southern.
You know, you got nothing on me.
Oh yeah? Well, we just pulled Ernie's dead body out of the dumpster behind your club.
That is circumstantial evidence, sweaty Eddie.
Call me all the names you want, but I'm still here, sitting pretty. Oh, just wait. We have a witness who's gonna put you away for good, Curtis.
They have a witness? Who'd they get to squeal?
I don't know. With all I've done, could be anybody.
Hey, that's Dolores' code.
Just gotta see that. Come on, so here's
the witness is Dolores?
Oh, crap!
Hey, look at me. Do I look nervous? We got everything right where we wanted, all right? They got Dolores. Fine, we'll get Dolores.
How are we gonna do that?
Don't you know who you're talking to? I know Dolores. I know the way that she thinks. I know her habits and kinks. I know the stuff she's all about. I know the people she knows and all the places she goes. I know her up, down, inside, out. I know the needs that she's got. I know what gets the girl hot. I know I've got the inside track. And yeah, I know she's upset. Well, let her play hard to get. Cause if I know one thing, I'm getting her back. Because I know that girl. I mean, I feel that girl. I understand that girl. And if I want that girl, I'm gonna get that girl. Ain't gonna let that girl get away. No way. And when I find that girl, I'm gonna kill that girl. Till that girl is safe and sound 6 feet below. No! When I find my baby, I ain't letting her go.
They can put her wherever they want to, boys.
But it's not gonna work. Sooner or later, she's gonna come back to what she needs most. Me. Wherever she's at, I bet she's trapped like a rat and pacing up, down, round the floor. I bet she's starting to sweat. That girl is bugging, I bet. Bet she's got one eye on the door. I bet she's missing her gigs. I bet she's missing her booze. I bet she's staring at her head. But she's missing the fun and getting ready to run. And when she does, you bet I'm gonna be there. I'm gonna shoot that girl and looking at a world of woe.
What I've been,
whisper in the background, the king of uncool. The first at the office, the last in the pool. And it's true. But what can I do? Tell me, why can't she see? There's much more to me deep within. Picture a guy. Get him staring at center of heads. Cool beyond comparing. A guide filled with pride and a spring in his stride and a fist full of style. And I could be that guy. I could be the back of the walk and the top of the town. In the back when the action goes down, yeah, I bet you I could say the words, no. If I only could try to lie, I could be that guy for her.
The sisters have made it clear to me that they followed you of their own volition. But they never would have ventured out in the first place had it not been for you.
I'm sorry, they just don't want to be stuck behind these walls all the time.
These walls are the only protection that they have.
But...
they are my sisters, and I will not allow them to be put into harm's way.
What are you going to do? Kick me out?
I will speak with Officer Southern, Monsignor O'Hara, tomorrow. Until then, I shall restrict your activities to a single task. You're a musician, true?
Oh, yes.
So you're comfortable working with other musicians, true?
Oh, yes. When it comes to working with others, I have a certain joie de vivre. It's French.
You could sing with our choir.
Are they any good?
There are no words.
Oh, that's nice. You see what happens when we talk? It's a beautiful thing.
Mother Superior.
Monsignor.
This Sunday, after Mass, we are to be visited by Mr. Swanson and a Mr. Lardner.
I do not know these gentlemen.
Perhaps you know them as the bachelors who deal in antiques. They've struck a deal with the Archdiocese and will be arriving check in hand. It pains me to tell you this, but this church will be no more.
But what of the sisters?
They will be split up, sent to various parishes. The older ones sent to homes.
But this is awful. What of my prayers?
Mother Superior, look around. God has answered your prayers. You just don't like the answer.
Here, God's own gift, celestial protector. Calls for the very best.
Come along, sisters, come along. We let you sleep till 4:15. This is in Club Med. Let us roll up our sleeves and praise the Lord with choir breath.
Is this rehearsal?
It sure is! Come on in, sing a spell. Soprano or alto.
Whatever you need.
Go sit in front of Sister Mary Stevens.
Good morning.
Good morning. All right. Mary Clarence, are you with us?
Pretty good, huh?
There are no words.
Thank you!
Right, let's take it from Benedicta in G. Mary Martin, up to it!
No, not him! Give us Barabbas!
What? Forget G. Just go sit over there. Okay. Why doesn't everyone just pick the key they like best?
Lift it up to heaven.
time for me, Mary Robert.
Why so quiet? Get right up and try it.
But your superior says you should sing modestly before the Lord.
And Mary Clarence is saying it's the word of God. Why hide it?
Hey, hey, sister.
Don't you deny it. Stand and sing with pride.
Go, girl.
Bigger.
Brighter.
The world is in sad and tall and proud. They don't know what they've been missing. It's heard that funny loud faces. Yeah.
And that is why we say Job got off easy. So welcome to you, the few, the last remaining Christians in the tri-state area. For our musical offering, the sisters shall sing for us. It is my understanding they are under the musical direction of Sister Mary Clarence. Well, she can't row it.
Supposed to go.
I don't care. Get her out now.
Take
You're throwing quite a few curveballs my way. Help me to understand what is your will. A sign. Give me a sign. Bless me, Father, for I have sinned. It has been 2 days since my last confession.
Mother Superior?
My God, she's everywhere.
Look, I know you don't trust me, but this can be bigger than Broadway, bigger than Vegas.
This is a house of worship.
I know, but that's the problem. You see, people like going to theaters, and they like going to casinos, but they don't like going to church. Why? Because it's a drag. Here's the church. There's a steeple. Open the doors. There ain't no people.
As of tomorrow, Sister Mary Lazarus will resume her leadership over the choir. This is non-negotiable. You are ruining the church.
I'm trying my best.
Bless me, Father, for I have sinned.
Yes, yes, I'm sure you have, and that's fine. But Mother Superior, people are hearing the music and coming in off the streets. They are throwing money into collections. This is a success.
It is.
And that is not all. The bachelors dealing in antiques love the service. They're going to donate the money they were using to purchase the church with to keep our services running. Here is the check.
Fuck.
And in the memo, they've written a special message.
Mary, you are fierce.
How much?
How did they know my name was Mary?
How much longer will Sister Mary Clarence be with us?
I have spoken with Officer Souther about transferring her to our reading, do you see?
Oh no, I do hope she can stay. I adore this music, Reverend Mother. Sister Mary Clarence is a godsend, and you are a visionary.
You're a godsend. I'm a visionary!
I can hear you smiling.
God has sent me here for a reason. Take the hint.
One hymn per service.
That doesn't include encore.
People, your vibrations are beautiful. I gotta tell you, this is a really big tabernacle, and you are filling it with a lot of love right now. Our sisters have worked up a nutty little number, which we think is really, really special. But first, a restoration fund. Let's see the tote board. Timpani. It's all about the love and the giving. You people are marvelous. Give yourselves a round of applause. In the name of the Father, the Son, and you know who, I give you Sister Mary Clarence and our own Queen of Angel Singers. Lay it on us, sisters.
Spread the news, it's time to rock the pews. We've got the Sunday morning fever.
If you see only one Roman Catholic Mass this season, let this be it!
Courier Post, I laughed, I cried, I felt the guilt of original sin.
Rocky, Chris, sisters, people are hearing the word of the Lord.
This is vibrant, then.
Sisters, let us assume an attitude of prayer. Hand me a Bible. Not the variety! Everything that woman does infects us more and more. Things were bad the way it was, but God, you're killing us with the cure.
And now we're back.
Let's take another look at that toe board. And we have the balcony open for the first time in 30 years. Let's hear it from the balcony. So let's get down on our knees and show the Lord how deep is your love.
Girls and boys can make a joyful noise and do the Sunday morning hustle. Pop that thing and praise and praise their king until you pull your pelvic muscles. Get confessed, get anointed, then get down like you were called to attend.
Lord, come here, you're in the paper. Everybody in the city is gonna see this.
This keeps growing, and crowds keep growing. The word is gonna spread.
Good for the moment.
Every mention just means more attention, and you won't be so fabulous if you're dead.
Now put your hands in the air and wait for all the time to pray. Let your fucking behavior so that you can stay here just like study and share.
Oh! I'm your relative.
I find that everybody has a truth that they hold dear. But the second a gun comes out and gets upside somebody's temple, things start to change. So let's see what truth we find now. I know that song.
That's the Lord's song.
Turn that up. Don't be a will, I'm a papal visit after all. Pope Paul VI comes to the city of brotherly love to see some sisterly love. Take it away, sister! None. The black one.
Hey, that's
real spill!
The Lord is a nut.
Say what?
Quick, listen, what church is it? This is Joe Pinocchio from Action News reporting from Queen of Angels Church. And now back to you in the studio. Dolores is hiding in a convent. You, scram. You tell anybody about this, you're dead.
What do we do now, boss?
Queen of Angels Church, South Philly. You know where she is. Now go get her.
But they're nuts.
Just get it done.
Oh. How are we gonna get into a house of nuns?
See, impossible.
I can get in. I can get in with any woman, even a nun. Watch and learn.
Dear God, I know you move in mysterious ways, but this one is for the books. I'm frightened. Everything I've devoted my life to is falling apart. Please, give me a sign so that I might have clarity and peace. I know my struggles pale in comparison to those who have come before me. Saint Anthony got visions in the desert. Saint Joan got voices in her head. Saint Ignatius got beaten, then partially eaten, and hung by the feet until dead. Saint Stephen got stoned, and Saint Francis disowned, all got tested and passed, as it were. And like it or not, just look what I've got. Her. And not just her. I've got disco piped into the cloister. I've got glitter wherever you gaze. I've got celibate nuns out there shaking their buns, shrieking you and your son's holy praise. I've got altar boys prancing in silver lame, requiem mass with the strobe light display. Lord, if you're testing my faith, may I say it's not fair, because of everything I've got, I haven't got a prayer. No, I've got fog machines clouding the altar, and a mirror ball over the ass. We've got half of a flock dressed to utterly shock, and the rest wearing moon boots or chaps. I've got vipers and addicts and punks in the pews, several drag queens and a handful of Jews. Lord, can you blame me at all if I choose to despair? I mean, how could I not? I haven't got a praise. I thought I'd get a glimpse of glory. I thought I'd get a taste of grace. I thought I'd get to bring your kingdom closer. I thought I'd get to make this fallen world a finer, gentler place, a haven for the soul, more safe, more pure, more people flailing their limbs, getting down to the hymns, while your sanctity dims day by day. And I don't have a clue what to do except to grieve. Don't know in what or in who to believe. Don't
haven't got a prayer.
I know I'm hearing you correctly. You are coming to get Dolores, and she no longer has to hide out at this convent. I'll get her right away. God, I never doubted you for a minute.
Bless our hearts, bless our souls.
coming to take you away.
Who's Dolores?
The patrol cars have blocked off our street. It's time to get your things, Dolores. I think the sisters should hear this from you.
Sisters, I'm not really a nun. I'm not Catholic either.
Oh!
You're still black, right?
I'm still black. I always will be. But, you see, I'm a singer. And I was dating a very bad man. And I saw him murder someone. And I'm going to court to say that. But first, I had to hide from him. Here.
So, you lied to us?
You should leave now.
I'm sorry, sisters. I guess this is goodbye.
For ye shall go out with joy, and be led forth with peace, and the mountains and the hills shall break forth before you into singing, and all the trees of the field shall clap their hands.
Isaiah 55 and 12. See you, sisters.
So, you lied to us?
Ah. I would. Come now, we've done the Lord's work. We protected a person in her time of need. Now let us go back to life the way God has planned it.
Dolores? Oh, you scared me. Tomorrow is the biggest day of our lives. How can you leave us now?
Baby, I gotta think about my own life.
Then I wanna go with you.
What?
I wanna go with you. Everyone else, they all know this is where they belong. They've all received their calling, but maybe this life isn't for me. Or maybe it is. I don't know.
Honey, I'm not a priest.
I know, but you're my friend. And I want to know what I'm missing. I've never talked back. I've never slept late. I've never sat down when I'm told to stand straight. I've never let go and gone with the flow. And you don't even know really why. I've never asked questions or taken a dare. I've never worn clothes that might make people stare. I've never rebelled or stood up and yelled or even just held my head high. And all of the feelings unspoken, all of the truths unsaid, they're all I have left of the life I never led. Surfing, or ran with a crowd, or danced on a table, or laughed much too loud. I've never rebelled, or stood up and yelled. I've just been too scared I might fall. I've never seen Paris, swum naked, been kissed. I've never quite realized just how much I've missed. And what did I get for hedging each bet? Another regret, and that's all. Taste of
have clung to my fears. Won't you help me let go? Help me let go.
Baby, you gotta do it on your own. You can leave or you can stay, but the change you're looking for, I wish I knew, but I can't tell you. Oh, hey, if you want a little adventure in your life, take these.
They're beautiful.
They're my FM boots.
FM?
FM stands for Father Mulcahy, and now the good work he did in Korea.
The blessed boots of Father Mulcahy.
Okay, honey, I just made that up.
I know. But I'll still believe in them. Thank you. Here, take my rosary.
But I don't believe in that. Take it anyway.
You might need some extra help.
Dolores, come on, let's go.
Where are we going?
I got the judge to move your court date to next Wednesday, taking me back to my place to hide.
Enjoy those boots, little sister.
I want to be brave. I want to be strong. I want to believe I'm where I belong. To stand up and say, I'm seizing the day. To not just obey, but to choose. And I may not surf, I may not see friends, but I have to know I still have the chance. And maybe I'll make a painful mistake. It's my love to take or refuse. And all of the doors left open, all of the rooms ahead, they're beckoning bright, scary and new. But I'm standing tall and I'm walking through. What's gone may be gone, but I won't go on playing dead. It's time to start living the life I never led.
Not much, but you'll be safe here.
No, you're a good cop for taking care of me like this, Eddie. Thank you.
It's nothing. Just doing what any good cop would do.
So, how did they find out where I was?
I don't know. I knew you kept it a secret between me, you, and the people who watch Channel 6. but they kidnapped some cab driver, and she escaped, and she came and told us.
Oh, I'm sorry.
That's fine. If you need anything, I'll just be right across the hall. Just knock.
You gonna come protect me, sweaty Eddie?
Yeah, well, I got my gun back now.
What do you mean?
You see, me and my partner, we got to a little situation a while ago, and there's too many people around, and I just couldn't do it. I couldn't shoot, so they took my gun away.
I'm sorry, Eddie.
I guess I should have told you that, huh?
Well, thanks for telling me now.
Hey, remember that play back in high school? You were the lead in it, and you directed everything for it?
Oh, yeah. It was an all-black version of Funny Girl. I called it, Girl!
Yeah, that was good.
Oh, thanks.
People who need people and all that.
Yeah.
Well, if you're hungry, I got you a cheesesteak.
No thanks. I'm all filled up. We had a big meal at the convent, but again.
Okay.
But I do like cheesesteak.
That's why I got it. Look how your eyes make the gloom ignite. Look how your voice sets the world alight. Look in my eyes and you'll know I'm right. Look at you through and through, your fabulous baby. You know, I always used to have a crush on you.
I know.
You're gonna be fine, Dolores. Cause with or without all the singing nuns, you're gonna shine like a million suns. You'll be fabulous, baby. Fine and fabulous, baby. Oh, my fabulous baby. I'll see you later, Dolores Van Cartier. You're gonna be a star.
Yeah, he's right. Gonna walk out the courthouse and find me nightclub to sing at. That's right, I'm gonna be a star! Gonna get me the agent, the money, the fame, the whole dream. I'm gonna do film, concert, television. Gonna knock the world out, and there ain't any fence I will swing at. I'm tomorrow's sensation, the new disco queen. The next I will tap out here, a record machine. A ball shot to be like the world's never seen. And now I won't miss that consistent routine. Ladies and gentlemen, Studio 54 and Studio 1 are proud to present Miss Dolores Van Cartier. Look at my star rising right on cue. Look at my dreams as they are come true. Look at me now, baby, take that view. Glitter, glamour, glory. Look at my act, baby, ain't you out? Everything goes and it's all allowed. I'm back in business with my home crowd. Thank you to all my fans. Give it up for me, come on, let me feel the love. Thank you, thank you. Thank you. Look at me, can't you see?
And no one's out. that fact. I'm part of one terrific sister act. And yes, I love that spotlight. Yes, I crave acclaim. I'll admit I love the sound when strangers scream my name.
Stick with good old Curtis, all right? Now put these on, and let's go get our girl.
But wait, Uncle Curtis, first. Boo! I'm sorry.
You see, I know that girl. I understand that girl. I see right through that girl, like straight into that girl. She's got no clue, that girl, that this will be her final show. Oh no! So when I find my baby, I ain't letting her go.
God, me again. Everything is as it should be. Your church is safe once more. Hello, sisters.
Good morning.
Now we must be joyful. We shall be singing Bach for His Holiness. Let us take it from D.C. Alfine. The D, of course, stands for...
Dolores!
No, it does not. It stands for...
Dolores!
Hey, sisters. I'm sorry, I'm not going to let you sing with the Pope without me.
Dolores, I'm impressed and quite frankly a little surprised that you came back here to help us. However, His Eminence will be here in less than an hour. We have new music to rehearse, and most importantly, your very presence here puts our entire community at risk. So I must ask you to leave for their sake.
No.
Mary Robert, this does not concern you.
I said no. Dolores is one of us. She's safe, and we all stand with her. No. I've always been good. I've always obeyed. I've lived as you've taught me. I've prayed as you've prayed. I've never once missed a rule on your list. I've done as a sister should do. Well, now I won't bend. Now I won't bow. My sister's in need of a sister right now, and I will not stay and blindly obey and just turn away from what's true. You promised one day God would call me. Isn't that what you said? Well, this is that day. This is that call. I'm either a sister or nothing at all. So she stays here now, or I'm leaving with her instead. It's time to start living the life I never lived.
What was that?
It's Curtis! Sisters, let's roll!
sisters, help me, help me!
Oh. 1, 2, 3, Jesus!
Come and get me, boys!
Hold on!
Oh, that's God, boss! We didn't need it, you did it! Oh, that's God, you have us, huh? Oh, that's God, you have us, huh?
Caused me all kinds of trouble, Dolores.
Oh, look at you and that little kid up walking around pretending to be a nun. You're a joke.
You sure as hell ain't no nun.
Yes, she is. She is a sister. Sister Mary Clarence is a sister as this convent has ever known.
Well then, Sister Mary Clarence, it's time for your last rites, right?
Receive my humble prayer. Faith that I bear. Accept my sacrifice.
Get out of my way.
Take all my heart and soul, my joy and love. I'm ready, sweet Lord above.
Of the world!
Jesus!